Hello there. Welcome to this live from Stamford Bridge, where we're building up to the FA Cup game between Chelsea, who, of course, will be looking to do something and win something this evening after struggling in the Premier League so far this season, up against Hull of the Championship. And alongside me tonight, nice to see you both, Chris Sutton, Owen Hargreaves. So, look, we've got a Facebook Live, and we thought rather than just doing this as a preview to the game, we would tackle a specific topic at the moment. Conte's future is uncertain at the moment. There's lots of chat about what's going to happen here. And it got us thinking, and we asked the question earlier on, is hiring and firing managers now the best way to deliver regular success? And it's interesting, actually, as you can see on screen here, this is split people. It's 52% in favour of yes, 48% are saying no. So we should get quite a good little debate going on this once you finish your cough. What do you think? Is it the right thing to do? Because if we take a look at the number of managers that Roman Abramovich has got through so far here, since 2003, there's quite a few of them, but they've kept winning silverware.
Well, they've won five of the last, 12 Premier League titles. I mean, they've won virtually every possible trophy since 2005, so I think they have had an enormous amount of success. I just wish they'd find a way to keep some of these managers for longer. They're having success, but it's like they're getting impatient. They're not being able to repeat that success from last season, and it looks like they get itchy feet or frustrated or whatever, and I think it's ridiculous. I think if Conte was to leave now, his stock would still be at an all-time high.
Yeah, look, I think Conte's a great coach. I mean, you can look at it both ways, though, can't you? Would Chelsea have won the Champions League had they not sacked Villas Boas? I think it was halfway through. Yeah. Lost 3-1 against Napoli. Di Matteo comes in, wins the Champions League. So, you know, you can argue that wouldn't have happened under Villas Boas. But it works for Chelsea. But what works for Chelsea doesn't necessarily work for every other club. I mean, you look back through historically Manchester United, Sir Alex Ferguson, 86 he took over as manager. I think he won his first league 1992-93 season. Would he have lasted in this day and age at the start? You know, maybe not.
Okay, here's a question straight in from O. Basley in 1979. Says, I think a lot of Arsenal fans, brackets myself included, will look on at this trophy haul with some envy. And you can see his point.
Yep, because, you know, the length of time Arsene Wenger has been at Arsenal, and has he taken the club backwards? Can Arsenal push for the Premier League title? I don't think so. So, in terms of Arsenal, I think it's gone the other way. You know, they needed to make a change. They haven't made a change to their cost.
So what's your problem then with chopping and changing managers if they keep on winning trophies at this football club? Does it really matter? They're just collateral damage, aren't they, in the grand scheme of filling the trophy cabinet here?
Yeah, but the remarkable thing is, people look at Chelsea and say they're struggling, even though they won the Premier League title two of the last three seasons. So maybe there is a bit of an identity issue there. I think Chelsea, how many players do they have on loan, those young players? 40-odd? The one thing I think this club is missing is a sporting director, a bridge between Abramovich and maybe the manager. And I think a lot of the frustration from Conte is in around transfers. How can you be at a football club and he can say, I didn't sign any of these players? If there was a sporting director there, obviously Emanalo has left, he's gone to Monaco, you would never have that issue. And I think that's probably one of the only issues Chelsea Football Club have. They have money, they have great fans, they have a beautiful stadium, they have success. But to even consider that they might not be a successful team because of some of the managerial changes, I think is bizarre.
Chelsea here and now, that's what the fallout is about, transfers. I think he did an unbelievable job last season, from 10th winning the Premier League, and then maybe Conte started to flex his muscles a bit, said, I want to fight on two fronts, my squad isn't strong enough. I think we all understood that if they wanted to compete in the Champions League, it wasn't. But then he didn't bring the players in, which he wanted. Maria Granaskara, I think her name is, seemed to be in control of the transfers. And that's where the fallout has come from. But you cannot doubt Conte's qualities as a coach.
Here's one from Danny Does on Twitter. He says, a stable philosophy is far more important than managerial stability. Bayern, Barca, Real Madrid have no issues with changing their managers. Only in England is it a topic of discussion, because largely the success of Sir Alex Ferguson, which I think just about every manager acknowledges, will never be repeated. And that's almost the point, isn't it? As long as they have that director of football, why does it matter whether it's Conte or Rafa Benitez picking the team, putting them out on a Saturday? If there's a person who's got that overarching view of the club.
But what is the philosophy? You know, Chelsea's philosophy
right now... Well, it's winning trophies, isn't it? Because they are.
It is, but Jake, 70% of the players they've signed, I think, in the last years have been 25 or under. So they're not really signing... Who's the last superstar Chelsea signed? Eden Hazard. They've signed a ton of players for fortunes, really, that haven't really dramatically improved the football club. And still, Conte is having a ton of success. I think if they had a bit more structure in place, then I think this club could compete to win the Champions League potentially every season.
But is it not the case at Chelsea now that they have the structure in place, but Conte wants to do it his way? Is that not what the fallout's
about? But he's arguing that they're not doing it his way. He's arguing the club are doing
it their way. But when he came in, if he wasn't in control of the transfers, now he seems to want to bring the players in, which he wanted. So he's not buying into what he was when he initially got the job.
But if he doesn't want to buy into what Chelsea are, off you go.
Yeah, but exactly. And that is it.
That's a great point.
And, you know, they rate Conte as a coach, but they're saying this is the way we do it here. And, you know, let's get it right. If there's a battle between the manager and the owner, there's only one winner, the Battle of Stamford Bridge.
Indeed.
As long as you're on the same page, I think, as a football club, David Gill, Sir Alex Ferguson, the players, everybody was on the same page. Yeah. Chelsea, the only criticism you could have of this football club is that they're not really on the same page when it comes to some of these issues.
That's a conundrum, isn't it? When you look at Sir Alex Ferguson, what he achieved at United, they won the Champions League 99, he was there from 86, didn't really achieve great things until they, you know, won the Premier League 92, 93. In this day and age, he would have been sacked. I think this season there's been, eight changes of manager in the Premier League, and seven of the managers have improved statistically their team, so it works for some, that quick fix mentality.
Okay, we've got another Arsenal fan that was clearly watching the answer to the last question. So Matt Arsenal 1 on Twitter, Chelsea's success isn't down to hiring and firing over patience, it's just down to the £1 billion worth of investment. What's the common denominator in the above? Roman Abramovich. I think the point that they're making is you could have had the same manager here for the last 10 years and won nothing, or you could have chopped and changed managers every season and won everything if you've got an owner that's going to spend money. Isn't that really what it comes down to?
Jake, that's not true. No? Who had the best squad in the Premier League last season in terms of overall quality? I know it's an opinion, but City and United. Chelsea weren't there. They had no right to win the Premier League, really, last season. They had a great coach. They got the players working. Just to say it's about spending money, Chelsea don't compete for the best players in the Premier League anymore. They just don't.
And what about Leicester City then?
Exactly.
Winning the Premier League. Nonsense argument.
Your question's answered, Matt, I think. Talk 3 says, what's happened to the youth training scheme that helped managers develop cultures and success? I suppose this brings us back to having a culture at a football club, really, isn't it? And making sure that no matter who the manager is, they might want short-term success, but it is about long-term planning.
I think the remarkable thing here is that this team, Chelsea, has the best academy in the country, has had for, 5 or 6 years. The majority of these players never get a look in at this football club. You know, I think they need to look at why do they have 40 players, talented kids, on loan? Why don't those players play for a Watford or a Milton Keynes?
But that's what they've sort of had to do, isn't it? But is it not the manager's right then to, you know, Conte's come in, he's won something, and he's sort of saying, well, to get to the next level, to compete at Champions League level, I want players who are up from what we're producing in the academy. And I think that's a reasonable argument.
I think you're right. I think that's all he wants. I think rather than sign 8 players, like he said, he probably just wants 3 stars.
Yeah. I mean, he doesn't want good players, does he? He wants
difference makers.
His players. Ian, on Facebook, does this culture problem make Chelsea a less appealing destination for a Simeone or a Luis Enrique?
If they want control, yes. Absolutely.
Isn't that one of the first questions as a manager that you would ask an owner, though? If they want you and they're going to pay the salary, the next question naturally is, how much control have I got?
Well, Simeone's not going to come here, is he? Just based on sheer style of football. I don't think that's going to happen. But you would have thought, with Conte coming in, you would have addressed a lot of those issues, that you're going to work with some of the younger players. And maybe that's where that sporting director is so important, to be a bridge in between Abramovich and the players, because I think that's where a lot gets lost, maybe, in communication, just therefore the lack of. And I think if they had that address, maybe an ex-player can come in and do that. You know, you think about some of the greats this football club have had, I think it would be it's one of the only things missing at Chelsea Football Club.
It'd be nice to know why Michael Emanuele left and why they haven't replaced him.
Yeah.
And I don't know.
We don't know. I think one final question then, this is probably the best way to wrap it up. Sean Hughes on Facebook, he says, straight to the point, guys, do you think Conte will go in the summer?
Yes. Absolutely. I just think this transfer issue is the biggest issue. I think Chelsea rate him as a coach, but they want control. That's the way they run the club.
And he wants control.
Yep.
And if he doesn't get it.
And so it's going to end.
I mean,
if he leaves, Chelsea lose. Conte's stock will still be at the highest. He'll get another great job.
They don't see it that way, do
they? Of course they don't. But I still think they're lucky to have a great manager in Conte like they have.
Will he go?
He'll go, but I hope he doesn't.
Okay.